like you're thinking.
So you broke it?
No, oh, did you?
Yeah, no, that was a good run. Both you and Sam look good. I think you made one silly mistake that I saw.
You can't complain that. Is there a lot of that?
Yeah, I can't complain.
I can't believe how much they've gone up.
So you can't use it.
I've got some orange.
Of course, we're going to the Hearts Regional next weekend.
Enjoy that, dibs. It was good. Oh, yeah, it was a bitch, but yeah, you got a bit of a nightmare. Oh, it was round two if you're not here already, please.
The shock of all.
It was bouncing all over the place.
What?
Yeah. Far too heavy the oil.
Yeah.
Far too heavy. I'm better off using the. What I've got on the other shop,
yeah.
Just maybe go.
Change the tyre because nobody runs zero outside, do they?
No.
I mean, that's.
I thought you'd put the guy to one or something.
Yeah, but the thing is, the more of it
doesn't
make anything
different. Only a cunt would run zero outside. So you've been off work then, Carl?
11 days now.
No.
Yeah.
Deal with it.
I think so, yeah.
You're really worried that you're
I can't remember what company it does now, but they do chassis skin. Is it Rd2 or something? Did you not get a thingy? You won a thing for that?
Yeah, TK. That's Richard Thorpe. It's Richard Thorpe's company, isn't it?
Yeah. Because they do real speed chassis skin.
Do they?
Yeah.
I don't know how
No,
I stayed the same. Yeah.
Looks right, doesn't it?
Yeah, it goes fine, yeah. Yeah, it was quite a smooth visit, to be honest.
What you changed then?
Sugar oil.
What? It did the same as me, put that on.
Yeah. Yeah.
It's just borderline cold, isn't it? Like here, it's not too bad.
It's fine. And you stood on rostrum. In the shade.
It just goes freezing.
Really cold.
Some heat. Yours looks alright, going round.
Yeah, yeah, it's pleased with it. Yeah.
Have I made any changes? I went lighter on oil in the shocks a little bit.
Track, isn't it?
Oh, it's lovely.
How far is this from you?
45 minutes. Yeah, it's close. Yeah. The bit I'm struggling at the minute is because this literally is the first week they've run it. Because I'm used to the jumps, then doing other things from the old track, I've done a whole year of racing that. Like when I come over that jump, that doesn't mean to go that way, it goes a different way. So I keep having to like stop my brain from automatically going a different direction.
Yeah. So they just sort of have one track change a year, sort of thing?
I don't know. Yes. I would have thought they would need a track change for the regionals again.
Yes, probably. And the national, of course.
Yeah. So maybe they've done this because it's perhaps a bit easier to just change some little things.
Yeah. Yeah.
very much so.
Out in the fresh air.
Yeah. In the same car, but like not using electricity, sort of being self-sufficient. I've got no battery.
Oh,
yeah, just because it's like, obviously I'm using it because charging up the iPad and stuff. But it's nice to be outside and you could come racing and be in the field and not need anything other than just your battery. Same old story though, isn't it? No matter what class you run, you just don't make mistakes.
Yeah, basically. Keep the lines tight, don't make mistakes.
Yeah. And go fast.
Go really fast. Yeah. Faster than everyone else. Yeah. You're ready for the Euros.
I haven't got much. I mean, I've got a brand new kit for the Euros, but I need to put that together. But I'll do that Monday morning and I pack up work Tuesday and go Thursday. So Wednesday I'll do bits and bobs. But yeah, it's not much to do really. I've got all the tyres sorted, three different types.
Running
Contacts and Hagbergs and stuff like that.
Just is that the
favourite? J or T with Contacts. I've got Hagbergs, Redbox.
I noticed there seemed to be a big change. Jumping on Hagbergs.
Yeah, they are, yeah.
Is that just a change of tide?
There's only one person that's driving that.
Really?
Yeah. The person that's selling it.
And it sort of made me chuckle when I was looking at it. It's like everyone's changed. It's like, that's obviously the annual tyre of choice now.
Yeah, that's it. Yeah.
You ready then, Carl?
Yes, mate.
Good luck, chaps.
Surprisingly bumpy.
Sorry?
I was quite surprised how bumpy it is.
It's always felt like that year to me. Yeah.
Maybe because the old track perhaps missed a lot of the bumps.
Yeah, yeah.
It seems to have picked a lot of the ripples up.
When I was watching that car go round on face paint yesterday, speaking to the car, it looked like it, like, oh no, I remember that now. I did, because his car didn't look particularly great. I thought, oh no, is that what it's going to be like?
Yeah, it's bad.
Yeah. They're amazing things, really, aren't they? They take all the bumps and jumps and you can race them. Have a good one, chaps. Yeah. You're next up, are you?
It was cold up there.
Done it.
Right, yeah. Thank you.
there, David.
I've been left for all twice.
Yeah.
My last two.
Yeah.
I wasn't really.
Yeah. Because that was good with you, Sam, and the other day there was three of you.
Second,
yeah.
So I've gone quite low, I've gone 17, but then I think it's so bumpy and amazing.
See, I'm looking at the one. Some of them sort of like sort of lower it and try and stop the next roll. You can have the daddy F on.
There's a trick in there.
No, you were weren't on track, you were on time. But when you were behind me, you were ahead on the clock because you started off.
No.
Before we were I couldn't get you straight away because there was a car coming. Some, what car I just did this time.
Yeah.
So, but I've suddenly remembered these are the ones I've used the last two times we were here. Look at that.
Two laps.
We were that much faster that I had to move out of the window.
Miles for that. That's
I caught you up, and so therefore, at the point that I caught you up and I was sitting on your tail for two laps, you are now slowing me down. It's now qualifying.
I see what you're saying.
You are now slowing me down, and so at that point, you should pull aside.
On my side of it, I just thought, well, I've had a couple of pretty slow laps at the start because I changed my ride height.
But that's your deal, that's not my deal. You've slowed up and I've caught you up. But look, I don't want this conversation over because we've taken hours.
Yeah, no, but we're
going to
be in the same heat again in a minute. Absolutely. So I just want to make sure that we're clear on
I'm totally clear. No. If a car comes up behind you, if a car catches you up, it's a done deal. You pull aside and let them through. That's it. It's done.
Well, you do normally wait like a lap or two, especially if you've made an hour.
If someone comes up and just closes the gap up, you stay out their way and you keep them going. Because it is not for you. Well, think about it with F1. When F1 goes through qualifying and people are going around, what penalties happen when a car interrupts that person's lap?
You mean Formula One,
qualifying. If someone interrupts someone's qualifying lap, what happens to that individual?
Well, I get what you're saying, but like normally, if you've made like a couple of errors and stuff, you don't necessarily move out of the way straight away. I just thought I'd had a couple of laps, I felt like I was impeding you.
We're clear on our sort of different views on it, which is totally cool. I get that. Everyone's not going to agree with what I think. We'll move on.
And obviously, I'm sorry for shouting at you as well. I was just a bit hacked off at the end because I was like, fucking hell, you hit me twice. I was just reacting in the moment.
Of course you are.
I totally get it.
It's all good.
I'm a big boy, so are you. How was
your run? Better with a softer shot. I need more steering. When I say steering, I say overall steering.
Yeah.
Shock springs were too soft. So,
I've seen 19 round though. Oh, great. Nice one.
Yeah.
They've asserted the same engine.
and I improved right for the second. Your defile. It felt so different though from the first one. You just had a few triangles here and there, didn't you really? Car looked good though.
Yeah, car's good.
Just need a bit of luck with them. Having a gap, don't you? You can get 4 or 5 laps.
Not so much, because I felt it started to get on my nerves.
No. I didn't realise how cold that is until you take that long.
Say again, mate.
I didn't realise how cold that was. Yeah, that sun goes in.
Really?
3 years almost, haven't seen a pool.
Oh, wow.
So I was just looking at
something.
Yeah, it's all gone out, Scott. All power's gone.
I'm okay. I'm on the 12 volt. When we've all been the slow one and we've had to let faster people through,
it's the changing of the guard though, which I think's not easy.
Yeah.
I'm not suggesting that's an excuse or a reason not to.
No, I know.
But, you know, I think ultimately what happens is there's a,
it's just
element.
It's just a bit of empathy to your fellow racer, isn't it?
The thing is though, that two people sort of see like you do, but you two saw it differently. And it would be interesting to have someone who is a natural, who watched it, who is, you know, experienced or a referee or whatever.
Just we run in the heat, are
they?
Didn't know if I was
going to
turn on. Someone in the pits has turned something on that shouldn't have been turned on. Like a power heater.
Ah, right.
An indoor heater outdoors, and you don't normally get this problem.
Did they get fined?
I'd like to find out who it was.
Not me. I can't afford a heater.
Can't afford that sort of luxury.
It cost a living crisis, so it's really bite. Someone put an indoor heater right next to him in the freezer and got him in.
My God.
It's not that cold, really.
It's not that cold.
No, it's a beautiful nice day. It's nice in the sun.
Yeah. You've got a great spot for you.
So there was times with bi-racing, as you start to race various different people,
I came to a point where me and Duncan Natris was always colliding.
Yeah.
And yeah. Then what happens is you either continue to collide or one just gets fed up the other and you move on.
Yeah, yeah.
But there is that time, I think, when you're both at that sort of pace.
Yeah.
That this will happen probably for the next X amount of weeks, potentially, until something changes. Whether the pace changes,
yeah,
and then one is noticeably faster than the other, and the other one is from the most.
But it's
difficult, isn't it? It's difficult.
Yeah, yeah.
I know it nearly. So. And ultimately, what happened as a result is you both ended up having a worse run.
Yeah,
so you both lose out.
Yeah.
But I let Steve Robinson through because he was just smooth and I was ragged all over the place. And I just thought, you know what? I let him behind and then tried to keep up with him.
Yeah.
And he flew round and I benefited from being behind him.
You always benefit by letting someone through.
It was so much
you
easier.
You always benefit.
Because I just knew he's and typically he doesn't tend to crash, does he? He's very consistent. Just the 15 changes.
For you. Is that all?
Yeah.
As long as you're having fun.
No, it's gone off again.
No, it's just died.
Just gone back out. Start on my charger for me, please.
Yeah.
That's what that says. Thank you.